Hey, Shams. Hey, people got a question for you.
Oh, yeah. Waste of time.
Oh, yeah.
Shams.
Yeah, I want to. The guys just called me. Look,
come on, quick.
No. It's a waste of time.
I want to ask you. Every time you ask,
Hey, Alan has two right hands. Is that literal or no?
Yeah, that's what I want
to
ask.
Two right hands. Yeah.
I have to go. I told you I have to go. Okay.
Quick, very quick.
You want clarification for the right hand?
Yes, because what you say, you say Christians lie, and say Allah has two right hands.
They
but you're doing ta'wil.
It's not ta'wil.
All right.
Okay, what is ta'wil? Define ta'wil.
Given a allegorical interpretation to something.
Allegorical explanation, was it?
An allegorical explanation.
Define allegorical.
Like, for example, people of Sunnah al Jama'ah, they'll say Allah has a body, right?
No, they don't say that.
Or has... not a body, but has two hands, a face, blah blah blah. Some Muslims, if you ask them, they'll say no, Allah doesn't have anything. They'll just say this is allegorical.
No, but they ask you that.
What I'm saying. So I'm saying it's an allegorical interpretation of something because you said it means Allah's hands are blessed or His power.
No, they say that.
You said can you clarify what you said.
So anyway, first
I'm paraphrasing
of
what
first
you
of
said.
All, that's what that's this subject of. The ta'wil, there's two types of ta'wil. There's a praiseworthy ta'wil and a blameworthy ta'wil. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned in the Quran, وَمَا يَعْلَمُ تَأْوِيلَهُ إِلَّا اللَّهُ وَالرَّاسِخُونَ فِي الْعِلْمِ. That no one knows the ta'wil. The ta'wil has been used here. So ta'wil, there's three meanings for ta'wil. There is the explanation of the verse.
Yeah.
Okay. And there's a ta'wil, which is the ta'wil, which is the reality of something. Reality. Okay. For example, Day of Judgment. We don't know Day of Judgment, how it will occur. So the ta'wil of it, meaning the meaning of it and the reality of it here, is belong to Allah. Now let's go back to the right hand.
Yeah.
The right hand, the hadith. Prophet Muhammad SAW mentioned that there is yumna. Yumna because why? There's another narration. Prophet Muhammad SAW said Allah has a right hand and a left hand. Are you aware of this narration?
Go on, make your point.
No, I'm asking you, are you aware or not? Just answer.
I'm aware.
You're not. When is this narration?
Where is it? It's in Muslim or something like that. Sahih Muslim.
Where?
I don't know. Is it Sahih Muslim?
Is it
in Sahih Muslim, okay. Yes or no?
So, wait.
Is it in Sahih Muslim?
No, it's not Sahih Muslim.
It's not in Sahih Muslim.
It's in Muslim Sahih.
Okay, same thing. You see? So I know it, what you're talking about. So don't say I don't know.
So now when the two right hands been explained, Prophet was speaking about the Arab, when Prophet said that. Allah has a hand,
okay,
and it's a right hand and a left hand.
All right.
From the Arab culture, the pagan culture,
okay,
that the left hand is not blessed.
According to who?
To the Arab culture.
Okay.
So Prophet Muhammad is speaking to Arabs. So Prophet was to clarify, even Allah has a right hand and left hand, but kiltahuma yumna. Yumna is being used here.
Okay.
There's two roots for it. One of them is which is called tayammun, blessed. Okay. So there is no ta'wil here, which is the incorrect ta'wil. This is correct ta'wil. Why is the correct ta'wil? Because you go in line with the other hadith.
Okay.
What the Christians cannot understand,
all right,
when it comes to hadith, you compile all the other hadith together to understand the correct meaning of the hadith. Some of them has been narrated by meaning, some of them by wording. Is that clear?
Now, my thing was this.
No, forget about your thing.
Let me respond.
Paper, will you stop me to ask me a question?
I'm going to make a statement because you made an accusation against the Christian community. Now, I'm going to clarify because what you did, you lied upon the Christian community to say that they lie about what the Hadith says.
Yeah, yeah.
Now, I'm going to go to a Sheikh, Abu Usama Atanhabi. And if anyone doesn't know who he is, he's a...
Azhar.
He's in what mosque is it?
He's alive.
So this is
he's alive.
He's alive. He's an American national.
He's what?
He's
what?
He's an American national who studied at the University of Medina in Saudi Arabia.
Okay.
So he's qualified.
No, he's not qualified because why?
What's your qualification?
Okay. Wait.
What's your qualification?
You allow me to finish. I
just want that one question because I'm going to show you
bro.
What he said.
No.
I just want that. Just what are your qualifications?
Why, bro?
I'm making a point.
Bro.
He's going to go into.
You asking me a question, so allow me to answer. Don't dictate to me. First of all, as Shamsi, everyone clarified many times on the camera, except the donkey cannot understand my clarification, that I said many times when I narrate speech or when I bring opinions about Islam, it's from the scholars. So who said that? Sheikh Salah al-Sheikh. You know who's that?
Okay,
he's the Prime Minister of Islamic Affairs in Saudi.
Okay.
So Abu Usama Dhahabi is like chicken to him.
Okay, now listen to what he says.
Khalas.
Okay, he's going.
Usama Dhahabi.
Wait.
Sorry.
Because the thing is this.
Take a look yourself because I have to go.
All right, so he's running away. The
BHD
is running
away.
Don't run away.
He's a liar.
No, he's a liar.
I'm going.
Listen.
Bro, you can speak to him.
So you can rebut him. Shabs, where you running, Shabs?
He's walking.
Why are you running, Shabs?
Let's put it on camera because this guy is a shake and running away. That's what he's
running away, Shabs. Hold that tight, Shabs.
But let's see.
Let's see
what this shake says.
What does he say?
Look.
When the reality of the issue is that Allah Azzawajal created Adam with his own hand.
Listen.
And in our opinion, that we should know understand that Allah Azzawajal has two hands. And both of his hands are right hands. And both of his hands, they befit his majesty. It's not for us to try to figure them what's the reality, to ask about the detail. We say we hear and we say that we obey.
So now their own scholar, Sheikh, has said, as a Muslim, you say Allah has two right hands, but you are not allowed to say how. So how is he lying on the Christian community to say we invented this interpretation on the hadith when one of their own Islamic scholars or imams has said the same thing? So Christians are quoting their own people. So this is what I wanted to confront him about. He's run away. Because Christians did not invent this. Their own people are saying Allah has two right hands, but you cannot say how it is. So therefore we have clearly shown
that
Shamsi is a kadab. He lies upon the Christians and people believe him. But he's the biggest liar in the park. Why is he lying upon the Christian community?
One last time, Shams, come.
But he doesn't want to hear.
One last chance, Shams, hey. One last time.
But clearly, we can clearly see
that
we did not invent it.
Play it again.
He doesn't want to hear.
Play it again. Play it again.
Let's hear it again.
My man lost, you know, fully up
here. No, stay.
Shams, you said to him about 5 minutes and all he right. went.
Yeah,
so
bring him though to rebut this.
He doesn't want to rebut.
Shamsi!
Let's see, because remember, guys, Shamsi said about Allah having two right hands.
Yeah.
Let's listen to what one of their scholars has said.
Play it again.
When the reality of the issue is, number one, that Allah Azzawajal created Adam with his own hands. And in our aqidah, we should know, we should understand that Allah Azzawajal, he has two hands, and both of his hands are right hands, and both of his hands, they befit his majesty. It's not for us to try to figure them what's the reality, to ask about the detail. We say we hear, and we say that we obey.
Now, he clearly said Allah has two right hands. And Allah, Shamsi, I asked him what is his qualifications. Now this guy, his name is Abu Atanhabi, and he studied at the University of Medina in Saudi Arabia. He knows what he's talking about. We have Shamsi, who has a PhD in Speaker's Corner and a doctorate in running away from debates. So how is he going to say the Christians are lying that Allah has two right hands when clearly their own scholars say the same thing? So this is what he does. That's why I said he's doing tawil. He's given an interpretation on something that's allegorical. But clearly, as a student of the Sunnah al-Wal Jama'ah, you say Allah has two right hands, but we do not know how, and it is befitting of His Majesty. That's all they can say. But clearly, he's going against what people teach. And we can even see like what a lot of Muslims say about Shamsi online. Look at some of these comments. Daniel versus Shamsi is basically a non-Muslim versus a non-Muslim. Getting criticized from his own community. It says, why am I not surprised? Shamsi yesterday was a non-practicing sinful street thug who now put on a thobe to tell people it's okay to love a country that's disobedient to Allah. Alhamdulillah, we do not take our religion from him and we are not in need of his misguidance. So clearly, the Islamic community is trying to refute this guy. Ali Dao called him what? A cult. And that's why I blatantly came to him with this. He gives his own interpretation, then he names scholars no one knows of, or he'll just say something to sound good, or we can bringly reference everything. We've got another comment from YouTube. It says, why is Shamsi arguing with atheist points against the Bible? And then we've got one more. Shamsi, stop doing dawah because you lost the pathway of truth. You are attacking Al-Azhar. And you heard a minute ago, he was attacking Al-Azhar as well because I cited him. One of the best Islamic universities had some of the best scholars.
Maybe Lami knows. Ask Lami. Maybe Lami knows about the two right hands. Ask him.
But say we do not know how.
I'm waiting for him.
I don't know if you saw that video of Shamsi.
Shamsi doesn't know anything. Why are you asking?
Thank you very much. At least you're honest.
Go on,
he invents his own Islam.
What did he say?
He will say Allah does not have. He said Christians lie upon the hadith and say Allah has two right hands. He says Christians lie upon the hadith and say Allah has two right hands. And I just played a video of one of your sheikhs confirming that Allah has two right hands. He said, do not say how or what it looks like, just affirm it and that's it.
Alright, can I come back to you? I'm not very knowledgeable in Islam. I mostly talk about history and culture. But just to speak about this, from what I know, and please don't debate because I don't want to debate. What I know is that when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when God speaks about, because you and me, we haven't seen God. We haven't seen the creator. Not Jesus, but the creator.
Right? Yes.
Now we haven't seen God. So when God says that, for example in the Bible, in his hands, he's got the whole world.
Yes.
Right? That doesn't literally mean that God has major human hands holding the whole world. But for us to understand God, it would come to a human level mentality to give us analogy of what we can understand of the world.
So what you're doing is ta'wil.
Even know what that means.
Yeah, but this is an allegorical, because obviously Shamsi is from the school, he's a Salafi.
Yeah, I'm a Muslim.
Because his school of thought, they take the Quran literally, everything. So they affirm, as you will say, it's allegorical.
Yeah.
But what I'm saying is he has affirmed many times, he believes in this school of thought where Allah has literal body parts. We don't know how, but he sits on his throne. He has a body in some sort of capacity.
You know, even the word throne,
he affirms that, but now, he's now said something's allegorical, so he's even going against what his own beliefs are. And he's accusing Christians of inventing this.
Inventing what?
That Allah has two right hands.
So do you believe Allah has hands?
According to your sheikhs, they affirm he has.
No,
but they say...
According to Christianity, do you believe that God has hands?
In Christianity, it's very different. The Bible is written in, we call it something called the theory of accommodation. So as you're saying, God communicates in a way we can understand.
Yeah.
But I'm saying within Islam, Islamic
thought... So do you agree with what I said?
I'm not a Muslim, so I cannot affirm. Because Allah says he has a throne that he sits on, he has a face,
For you and me to understand, we have to come from where you're coming from. In Christianity, do you believe that God has hands and arms like us?
In Christianity, we say God's a spirit. He's not like a physical entity.
Okay.
So within the school of Sunnah al-Wal-Jama'ah, they say you have to affirm it as Allah has these things literally, but how, we don't know.
Okay.
So you're obviously, because you're more of a layman Muslim, so you'll just say
is allegorical. I'm not layman Muslim, but what I'm trying to tell you is this, yeah? As Muslims, God speaks to us, right? And he tells us about, for example, as human beings, let's start from here. As human beings, we cannot imagine anything outside.
Okay,
let me finish, man. I will say something. Don't interrupt me because I love you.
Okay.
As human beings, we cannot imagine anything outside the universe or anything outside our world or anything outside our realm in that sense. But for us to understand what's outside our realm is to kind of, compare to what we know of, right? And then later on, once we do this research, then we can come up with, okay, this could be wrong, this could be right. You get me? So when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, or when God speaks to human beings, right? I don't know whether God is a being, right? He exists. He's the creator of the world. How he created, we don't know, but he created the world. Has he got hands? We don't know, right? But God says that biyadillah, in the hands of Allah, right? So basically, God fed us in the hands, you know, he feeds the world, you know, in the hands of Allah, you know, yirziku Allah biyadi. something like that. God refuses with his hands. So we're not taking this as literal. I'm not saying God has no hands. I'm not saying he has hands. But whatever God says to us is for him to understand from a human level. That's what I think.
Yeah, but that's what I'm saying. Now, your school of thought is one of they'll call Tawil, because this is Islam QA. The divine attributes are to be affirmed in the literal sense, not metaphor. And this is by a big shape. Now, this is what they say. They say the correct belief should be based on what is proven by the Quran and Sunnah, as understood by the early generations, the Salaf. That's why they call them Salafi, because they take everything as they believe the earliest generation believed it. So that, all I'm saying, that's what his school of thought. So he says, of this Ummah, namely the Sahaba, Tabayin, and leading scholars, they were unanimously agreed that the divine attributes mentioned in the Quran and Sunnah are to be affirmed without discussing how or likening to him, to his creation, and without denying any of his attributes or interpreting them in a way different from the apparent meaning. We do not differentiate between any of the divine attributes, no matter what category they come under. Every divine attribute that is mentioned in the Sahih text must be affirmed. So that's why when I said to him, when he said that Christians lie about Allah having two right hands, I said, no, as a Muslim, according to his school of thought, obviously you may not agree with that, you have to affirm Allah has two right hands, but you say, I do not know how. But then now he's saying it's allegorical, but then I'm bringing him a sheikh to say, no, as a Muslim, you're supposed to do it like this. What you're doing is tawil and giving it now a metaphorical sense. But then your line saying the Christians invented this, when clearly they didn't. And that's what I was calling him out before.
It's not a metaphor. Look, when God says that he's got hands.
Yes, right? But that's what I'm saying, you're taking it.
God has something.
Yes.
I'm not saying he hasn't got something, he's got something.
Yes.
But whatever he has, we don't know.
Yeah.
And we can never know.
Yeah.
But the best way that we can understand God,
yeah,
is to come to a human level,
yeah,
or human, so that we can understand him. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
For example, if God spoke about things which are in the heaven,
yeah.
Okay, let me give you an example. There's a hadith that talks about heaven.
Yeah, I understand your. I understand your principle, because you're coming. That's how, in a sense, a Christian would say when God says something about his hands or attributes, then we take it in a figurative way. Okay. But it's obviously because his school of thought again. Because if you ask a lot of the more learned scholars, they will say no. You have to take it in a literal sense. Obviously people like you may not.
I wouldn't say more learning.
The big scholars in Saudi Arabia as well. If they're Salafi.
Wait.
So people that call themselves Salafi.
Salafi is not Islam and Islam is not Salafi. You know what I'm saying?
It's
a sect.
Yeah.
I don't believe in sects.
Yeah.
Right? I see all Muslims as Muslims.
Yeah.
I don't believe that. For example, within Salafism itself, there's a problem. Mm-hmm. Sorry, I have to say this in a Christian YouTube channel, but that's the truth, right? There is the division within Islam itself. So what I'm trying to say is that I'm a Muslim.
Yeah.
I do not follow no Salafi, no Shi'i, no Sunni. I see all Muslims one. Now coming back to your point, more learned. Look, most of these people, they quote scholars more than the Quran and the Hadith. So that's not more learned. If you're quoting more, so basically, I'm explaining this to you so that you know the people that you're taking from. Most of them are actually quoting human beings who are infallible. Sorry, who are basically infallible.
Yeah.
You understand? So long story short, what I'm trying to tell you is that if you want to know about Islam, go to the Quran and the Hadith and see what the Quran and the Hadith says. Does the Hadith say we should take it literal, or does it say we should take it? Don't listen to these people. For example, now you showed me an article written by certain people. It does not quote the Hadith, it does not quote the Quran, but rather it quotes what? A sheikh. And a scholar. Why is that? There was a debate a few years ago. There was two sects. None of them quoted the Quran. It's shocking, but none of them quoted the Quran. They were books on top of each other.
Mm.
So right now we have placed scholars above the Quran and Hadith. So I'm telling you this because I want, as a Christian, please go to the Quran and the Sunnah.
So you think people like Shamsi have placed the scholars above the Quran?
Yeah.
Okay.
If you go to Shamsi right now, most of it what he will quote about, for example, if there's a different sect and you're trying to talk to him, he will quote, they follow a certain sheikh who believes that the Arabs should be above they believe that the Arabs should be above the rest of the world, right? After al-alam, simply because the Prophet comes from it. And that's a lie. The Prophet's not an Arab. When we trace his lineage, Ibrahim or Abraham comes from the land of Ur. That's historical. Right, that's the land of the Persians. right? So by root, the Prophet is a Persian, not an Arab. It just so happens that he was born in an Arab world. The Quraysh are not Arab. This happens that they married within the Arab females, not even the males, because the male lineage always continues. You get me? So in that sense...
So then how would you then interpret the Quran if you read something in the Quran?
How would you, what do you mean?
Like if you're reading Allah's attributes or even just certain verses, how do you then get clarification from vague verses or something? Because obviously you said people quote scholars, so...
That's a good question. Look, there are things that we should... For example, these scholars, the so-called scholars, they differ on many ideas. And most of them, they add, philosophical ideas to it. There are people that I follow, and these guys hate them. They hate them, you know why? Because these people that I follow, they believe that, you know what, despite the little differences about the sexism in Islam, we should come on the table and discuss the differences, but still unite under the Quran and the Hadith. Forget the sexism. These people don't want that. And these people that I'm talking about are Mufti Menk, Sheikh Raghi, Saeed Raghi, Nu'man Ali Khan. Listen to, if you want to know the Quran, this guy knows the Quran from page to page, and he will tell you.
Wasn't that who Yaqub brought in his debate about Solomon, Mufti Menk?
I think so. Yeah, but Mufti Menk, look. When you wanna know who's right, who's wrong.
Yeah.
See, these people, they got a little, they move in gangs, isn't that? Right, they always, look at them, they're always moving in gangs.
Why was Shamsi lying about the Christians, that we invented?
Come off camera if you want to ask a question.
Yeah, you can ask me. You can answer. You can answer off camera.
I'm his crypto guy. That's why he's running away.
Yeah, you can answer off camera. Why was he lying on the Christians to say we invented saying Allah has two right hands?
Don't touch my camera.
We can speak off camera.
Take the walk if you want to take the walk, it's fine. We'll walk, don't worry.
But yeah, that was just my main issue with Shandy, because he tried to say we were lying about something, when we said Allah had two right hands, but Christians are just getting from the Salafis. So it's not our fault if there's a pot. But we're not inventing it. He's saying we just got this from the Hadith and lied upon what the Hadith is saying, but. If we're showing some scholars, you may not agree with them, but if they're saying, then people are just listening to, it's not our job to interpret what's there. We're only saying back what the scholars say. So you cannot then lie and say the Christians are lying upon something when we can see within that Islamic tradition. Maybe not everyone may agree with it because you don't, but we've not lied about it. We're just quoting your scholars. So if you were talking about Christianity, people here quote Bart Ehrman, for example. I don't follow Bart Ehrman, but they'll still quote him and say, oh, but your scholar said, do you know what I mean? So it's that same thing. So as long as you're citing a source, then fair enough. But he's obviously lying upon the community, and we can clearly see as well, you believe that Salafis are quite a fringe.
Yeah, fringe, within the Salaf itself, it's broken.
Yeah.
So all I believe in, one Ummah, one Islam, one God, one religion, one people. That's what I believe in.
Thank you, God bless you, bro. Hey.